Hello everyone and welcome to another video tutorial with GUI. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn the timer function.
For timers, the MATLAB software includes a timer object that can be used to schedule the execution of MATLAB commands. Now, here are the steps involved in creation of MATLAB object. First one is to create the timer object. Here we use timer function to create the object. The second is to specify which MATLAB command you want to execute. Here timer object properties to specify the information are used. Third one is start the timer object. After creation of timer object, start using with push button. And finally, to delete the object when the execution and work is done. The final layout will be like this.
So let's start the ride. Follow the regular procedure. Here we'll just need a edit box to enter the value for timer, and another one will need a push button. So this is the final layout after proper editing. Let's run this to save. Okay, now we'll need to program push button. So callback. Now here we have extracted the edit box as handles.edit2 as argument as usual. Now here we have used the timer function, which is the soul of this program. Now we have provided another argument as start delay. So if state is true, then we'll pause from we'll get into loop and we'll pause for 1 second for every iteration it make until the value we have entered, that is n. So until it reaches to n, the for loop will continue executing, and as soon as the condition is false, it will get out of for loop. So let's run this program and see what happens. So we'll enter value 10, start. So as you can see here in the command window, after 1 second values are refreshing, and after reaching 10 we are getting the message timer. So after running timer, here is extension, that is digital clock, which will be synchronized to original timing. Now here we have extracted few of the arguments from UI control and the figure. Here we have initiated timer object and we have provided proper arguments such as name, reminder period of 60 seconds. Here we have provided another argument, that is tasks to execute, along with information, which is number of times to update the task. And we have written a simple function, that is to update R. Now you can get the code by clicking on the link in the video description down below. So this is pretty much it. Now we'll run the program. So as you can see, it is showing time as 4:44 pm, which is roughly the exact time. So this is about it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any thought, any suggestion, please leave it in the comment section down below. So that's it for now. Thank you so much for watching the video.